What's happening, humans? How have you all been? 10,000 subscribers. Whew. You know, for a person who started YouTube way back in 2014, it's very unlikely that somebody who's serious with YouTube would reach 10,000 subscribers this late, like 7 years away. They usually reach much earlier because, you know, they play the game. But I refuse to play the game. I only wanted to play the game that I wanted to play. Make whatever videos that you want to. Make whatever kind of content that makes you happy. Did not stick to one particular niche. I did reviews. I did movie reviews. I did food reviews. I did travel vlog. I did cooking videos. God damn it. I did a lot of things on this channel. Safe to say that, you know, I confused most of the viewers out there. I confused the fuck out of them. I did not stick to one particular thing. A subscriber probably got my channel because they liked cooking videos and they subscribed, and then poof, gone. There's no more cooking videos on this channel anymore. There are snack reviews, or there is movie reviews for all I know. This guy with the beer is just reviewing everything under the sun. So I think that is why YouTube did not really push me. And I don't think so even now YouTube is pushing me, because the only reason I've reached to 10,000 subscribers is because of the shorts. Say Kantara movie review, which really hit like 650k views. Wow. That gave me a lot of subscribers, and they probably are thinking, when am I ever going to do another movie review? The other video, which is really doing well, very popular even right now, is the La Pino's Pizza review, which hit 1.6 million views as we are recording this, and that is massive. And that is a shorts again. And the other one which is doing well is how to upload high quality videos, which is a shorts again. So it was safe to say that YouTube never pushed any of my long format, or it never pushed any of my horizontal videos. I mean, it did push, like, you know, Ayatana. And I cannot say YouTube, I should say I never played the trending game. I never made videos which were actually trending, which is my bad. But, you know, I was always the kind of a person who's like, I'm gonna tell stories. Maybe it be a cooking video, or it could be a review. I mean, I don't know how much of a storytelling a review video can do, but I'm still really proud of my Ayatana video. I'm still really proud of my travel vlog, Pondicherry one. I'm still very proud of my shorts as well, because, you know, the shorts did not really take lesser time. It took more time to do it, and to keep uploading shorts was a big task. But here we are, 10,000 subscribers and so many videos. I don't even know how many videos. So many videos later, I'm sitting here and I'm still thinking, I do not know what the fuck to do on this channel. I do not have a niche. I don't have a category. I was nowhere close to be a qualified snack reviewer, or, like, you know, food reviewer. I was not qualified for any of that. I'm not even a movie critic. You know, recently we had a son, and when I was spending time with him in the beginning, and I completely stayed off social media completely, and when I was spending time with him, and spending time with my wife, and when we were embracing this new human that's coming to our life and taking care of him and everything, we just wanted to make sure that he knows his parents for the best that we are. And me, I wanted to make sure that my son knew exactly what he was getting as a father. I don't know, very, very weirdly, I did not want my son to see his father as a person who reviewed snacks. I did not want my son to look at those videos and say, like, yeah, all my dad did was just eat snacks and just review. What I wanted for my son to actually realize or think about or discover his father as on the internet is that my father is a storyteller. If you have not watched the documentary, the 9 months pregnancy documentary that I did, I don't know if you've not watched it, I think it's the right time you should go watch it. I think when my friends watched it, and when I watched it over and over again, when my wife watched it over and over again, I kind of realized how much I loved storytelling. Shooting a documentary, kind of a short film for 9 months and still sucking at it, it gave me great joy because I wanted to do what I wanted to do best. That is, tell a story. I did not think of anything else. But I think now with this channel, what I want to do is I want to put forward more and more videos where it's more of a storytelling rather than just a random thing. Maybe I like to make more videos with my son. Maybe I will put them as videos, you know, maybe that's what I'm looking to do. But right now, as I sit down and as I sip my whiskey, you know what, congratulations to me, and thank you so much to all of you who've been with me right from the beginning. Cheers to you guys, cheers to me. Let's drink.
That's a nice whiskey.
Maybe now I want to use this channel to tell stories, to focus more on making short films, to focus on keeping the cinematography of the videos to what I like to do best, and to keep it in monochrome. I want to tell stories in black and white. Will those stories be about my son? Will those stories be about my wife? Will those stories be about myself? Will those stories be about us? Or will those stories be completely something different? I have no clue. But what I know is that I don't want to let 10,000 subscribers down by not posting. I mean, I don't know if 10,000 subscribers really give a damn. But even if 5 or 10 or 50 or 100 of them care, I don't want to let you down. And most importantly, I don't want to let my wife down and my son down. Now, I don't want them to feel that Papa is just doing this whenever he feels like it. I want them to feel like Papa is doing this because he loves to do this. I want to tell more stories. From next video onwards, I'd like to tell a story, one video at a time. That's about it. My name is Sai Sandesh Malcolm, and I'll see you on the next one. Bye.